In this video, we are going to discuss about the blood, the transportation in plants and circulation in animals. So, as we all know, the blood is the circulatory medium in the human body. And it connects the other parts. So, it is flowing throughout the body and it connects other tissues also. So, the blood is connected with all the tissues. So, it is called as connective tissue and the color of the blood is red. So, components of the blood. So, the blood components is plasma and the blood cells are formed elements. So, the plasma is fluid in nature. So, first we will see the plasma. So, plasma is slightly alkaline, containing non-cellular substances which constitute about 55% of the blood. So, it is alkaline, containing non-cellular substances and 55% of the blood is plasma. Organic substance is also seen in plasma, that is proteins, glucose, urea, enzymes, hormones, vitamins and minerals are present in plasma. And now we will see the formed elements of the blood. Formed elements of the blood is nothing but the blood cells or blood corpuscles is of two types. Red blood corpuscles, RBC or erythrocytes. WBC, white blood corpuscles or leukocytes. Blood platelets or thrombocytes. First we will see the red blood corpuscles or erythrocytes. So, the red blood corpuscles, that is, it is seen in the human body. It is more in number in human body. So, they are the most abundant cells in the human body. So, RBC is formed from where? It is formed from the bone marrow. So, the RBC, why the RBC is red in color means, because of the respiratory pigment hemoglobin. Hemoglobin and this RBC transport the gases. So, due to the presence of respiratory pigment hemoglobin, the RBC is red in color. And mature mammalian RBC or erythrocyte doesn't have any cell organelles and nucleus. And the shape of RBC is biconcave shape. So, you can see the biconcave structure, okay, and disc shape. The lifespan of RBC is 120 days in male and 110 days in female. So, the transportation of oxygen from lungs to tissue that was taken place by this RBC cells. Next, why does the mammalian RBC lacks cell organelles and nucleus? So, the mammalian RBC lacks nucleus and makes the cells biconcave and increase the surface area for oxygen binding, loss of mitochondria, allow the RBC to transport all the oxygen to the tissue, and loss of endoplasmic reticulum allows more flexibility for RBC to move through the narrow capillaries. So, for the movement, the RBC doesn't have nucleus or mitochondria or endoplasmic reticulum. So, because of the absence of cell organelles, the RBC can easily move. That is, it is easily move and carry the oxygen to the other parts of the body. So, it will bind and easily move inside the blood vessels and pass on through other parts of the body. Why blood corpuscles or leukocytes? So, RBC is red in color, but WBC is colorless because they don't have hemoglobin and their cells are nucleated. But in RBC, there is no nucleus. But here, you have nucleus. And it is also found in the bone marrow, spleen, thymus and lymph nodes. So, it is found in the bone marrow, spleen, thymus and lymph nodes. So, the movement is, WBC movement is amoeboid movement. So the white blood corpuscles can be grouped into two groups or two categories, granulocytes and agranulocytes. Granulocytes, so they contain granules in the cytoplasm. You can see here, no? So this is, okay, like this. Okay, like this, the granules are present in the cytoplasm. And the nucleus is irregular in shape. So, you can see the shape of the nucleus here. So, it is irregular in, this is the nucleus and it is irregular in shape. Okay, irregular in shape. And the granules are of three types, neutrophils, eosinophils, basinophils. Neutrophils, so this is a neutrophil with two or seven lobe nucleus. So, this one here, they shown three. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So, 5 lobes, 2 to 7 lobes nucleus is seen in neutrophils. And this corpuscles that is formed 60 to 65% of total leukocytes. In WBC, neutrophils occupy 60 to 65%. So, their number are increased during the infection and inflammation. So, when the number is increased, when there is an infection or inflammation, the number of neutrophils will be increased. Eosinophils. So, eosinophils, it is two lobed, this one and this one. So, two lobed, that is, and in total leukocytes, its percentage is 2% to 3%. So, the number increases during the condition of allergy and parasitic infections. And it brings about detoxification of toxins if any poison enters through the some of the foreign particles, toxins like bacteria, virus, toxins. This eosinophil can easily able to detoxify the toxins. Basophils. So, basophils have lobed nucleus. You can see, so how many lobes? It is many. So, lobed nucleus. So, you can see this, the lobed nucleus. And the percentage here in total leukocytes is 0.5 to 1%. So, keep it this percentage. This they can ask in one mark. Okay. So, they release chemicals during the process of inflammation. So, the basophil releases the chemicals when the process of inflammation. Agranulocytes. So, granules are not found in the cytoplasm. You can see there is no granules here. Okay, in the previous picture, the granules were seen in the cytoplasm, but here there is no granules. So, because of that, it is known as agranulocytes. So, the agranulocytes are of two types, lymphocytes, monocytes. Lymphocytes, 20 to 25% of total leukocytes. So, it occupies 20 to 25%. And they produce antibodies for bacterial and viral infection. So, bacterial and viral infection, the lymphocytes produces antibodies. Monocytes, this is the largest of the leukocytes. This they can ask in your one mark. So, largest and the shape, that is amoeboid shape. The shape is amoeboid shape. And these cells form 5 to 6% of total leukocytes. So, total leukocytes 5 to 6%. So, they are phagocyting, means cell eating. So, they can engulf the bacteria. They will eat the bacteria when the bacteria enter into our body. So, that it find out and it engulf the bacteria. Blood platelets or thrombocytes. So, they are small, colorless. Okay, the thrombocytes are small and colorless. They do not have nucleus. So, the nucleus was absent, as well as in immature RBC, there is no nucleus. And same way in blood platelets also, there is no nucleus. And that is, there are about 250,000 to 4 lakhs platelets per cubic millimeter of a blood. That is, when you drop a lit, one drop of blood contains this much of platelets. That is 250,000 to 4 lakhs platelets. Okay. So, the lifespan of the platelets is 8 to 10 days only. Okay. And they play an important role in clotting of blood. So, platelets form clot at the site of injury and prevents the blood loss. More to known, anemia, that is decrease in the number of erythrocytes. Leukocytosis, so increase in the number of leukocytes. Leukopenia, decrease in number of leukocytes. Thrombocytopenia, decrease in the number of thrombocytes. So this from this they can ask for 1 mark. Functions of blood. So transport of respiratory gases, nothing but oxygen and carbon dioxide. Transport of digestive food materials to different body cells. So transport of hormones. Transport of nitrogenous excretory products like ammonia, urea and uric acid. And it is involved in protection of body and defense against diseases. It acts as buffer and also help in regulation of pH and body temperature. It maintains proper water balance in the body. Hope you understand the topic. If you have any doubts, post your doubts in the comment box. If you want to watch the video in Tamil, I had given the link in the description box. You can go and watch it. Give a thumbs up, share and subscribe to Science Easy Tech channel.